Hey guys, this is Cheyenne, and today I'll be talking about memoization and dynamic programming. Both of these topics, memoization and dynamic programming, are very important in computer science and algorithms. I assume that you are familiar with recursion. So if you didn't understand anything, you can watch my another video about recursion and then watch this video. Well, assume that, like I said in my previous video about recursion, assume that we want to calculate Fibonacci numbers. Well, Fibonacci numbers are defined like this. Each element is the sum of its previous two elements. So f of I is equal to f of I minus 1 plus f of I minus 2. Well, I implemented this code using this recursive function. As you can see in here, I said that if I is equal to 0 or it is equal to 1, return 1. Otherwise, return fib of I minus 1 plus fib of I minus 2. Well, this works, but we said this is slow. Why is this slow? As you can see in here, we see that, for example, fib of 3 has been calculated once, and we did everything, and we saw that it is equal to 3. But we do it once over again and calculate the same thing again and again. This makes our code slow. The answer of fib of 3 has not changed. It will never change. So why we are calculating it again? This is the key idea of memoization. This says that once you calculated something, keep that, save that somewhere. And if you wanted to calculate it again, avoid calculating it and use the previous value that you have already. Because the value has not changed and you calculated once, so you know what is the answer. You do not need to calculate it over and over again. So let's see how it works. Okay, as we can see in this code, we have calculated Fibonacci using the same function on instances of I minus 1 and I minus 2. So we just call fib of I minus 1 and fib of I minus 2, and we add them together and return fib of I. This works, but as we said, it has a lot of calculations that we don't even need, and we want to somehow eliminate them. What we do is to save the value of Fibonacci for all the values that we have calculated once. So if I assume that I only care about Fibonacci numbers from 0 to 100, so the size of my array should be 101. And I name it as f. So in f of I keep the Fibonacci number of element at element I. So it's just enough to say that I can say that here, I can save what is the Fibonacci number of I. And then return this f of I. And at the beginning, I can just say that if f of I was not 0, I can write it like this, or I can write it like this, or I even can write it like this. But to make everything simple, I just write f of I was greater than 0. I say return f of I. So if you have calculated before, if it is not 0, if it is 0, I say that, okay, I have done nothing to it because it is initially 0. But if it is now greater than 0, it means that I have calculated once. So I do not need to calculate it once again. I just return this value. So what happens in here is that when I reach fib of 3 here, I see that f of 3 is greater than 0. It is not 0. Therefore, I just return it and all these calculations will be eliminated. So I do not need any of them anymore. I see that I have calculated this value before, so I just return that. This way I calculate each number only once. And this makes my code very faster. So let's see whether it works again or not. I run this. and I just give 5 as the input, and I can say that yeah, it works. I can even give larger numbers since now my code is very faster, and I see that it gives me these numbers for the first 10 elements of the Fibonacci number, first 11 numbers. So this way we can make our code more efficient. And this is called memoization. We just memorize what was the answer of something. And when we wanted to calculate it once again, we stop and see that we have calculated it before. So we do not calculate it once again. We just return the previous value. This idea can be an introduction to dynamic programming. This approach is also called this approach memoization. Is also called top-down approach. We start from the top. We start from f of n or f of I, and we go down. We start from the larger number. For example, I start from f of n, and then I call smaller numbers, and I will go and calculate them. And once I calculated them, I memorize their answers. And I keep doing this. So this approach is gonna be the top-down approach. There is also another approach that we call this one dynamic programming. Well, the previous approach was kind of dynamic programming as well, but it is better to implement dynamic programming like this. This new approach that I want to tell you is called bottom-up approach. This time we start from the bottom. We start from the smallest value and calculate it, and we go to the top and calculate all the numbers. Let's see how this one works. Well, in here, I just forget about this function. And I just start from the bottom. And I will go like this. I say that f of 0 is equal to f of 1 equal to 1. I'm starting from the bottom. I'm starting from the smallest values. F of 0 and f of 1 are equal to 1. And then I'm gonna have a 4 from 2 to number n. And I calculate all of the values. I say that f of I is equal to f of I minus 1 plus f of I minus 2. Can you see what's happening here? I'm just starting from 0 and 1, and then I go on 2. First, I calculate 0 and 1. Then I calculate f of 2 using f of 0 and f of 1. Then I calculate f of 3 using f of 1 and f of 2. Then I calculate f of 4 using f of 2 and f of 3, and so on. So using the previous values, I'm calculating and find the answer for the next value. So this is the bottom-up approach. I start from the bottom and I go up. And let's see if it works or not. Let's just see out f of n. Let's just first see out f of n because we only care about f of n actually. And then also we can print all the f of i's from 0 to n as well. So cout and endl. Let's see how this one works. Let's give it 10 to it. Yeah, we can see that it's working properly. We just started from the bottom and we went up and we calculated all the values. So the point is, we only care about f of I. I just printed all the values from f of 0 to f of n minus 1 as well to see that how the sequence forms. I wanted you to see the sequence as well, but I only wanted f of n. I gave an n and I wanted f of n. So why I am calculating f of 0, f of 1, f of 2, f of 3, and so on as well? We do not need them. We only care about f of n. Why we define so many subproblems and we solve them as well? Well, the point is this. In dynamic programming, we define many similar subproblems and we solve all of them. Some of these problems are acting as an intermediate subproblem that are helping us to solve the original problem. So I want f of n, but the values f of 0 to f of n minus 1 are intermediate subproblems, which by solving them, they help me to calculate the answer for the final problem. So this way I can solve the final problem by defining so many subproblems and solving all of them. These subproblems are helping each other. By two other subproblems, I'm solving another subproblem. So these values are helping each other to being calculated. So this is how dynamic programming works. You need to define so many subproblems which are acting as intermediate subproblems. You are just solving them because they are going to help you to solve the original problem. They are going to help you to solve other subproblems and also the original problems in the end. So this is why we are solving so many other subproblems as well. So as the challenge, let me also give you another problem. Assume that we have a 1 by n rectangle. So it's like it has n cells. We can make each cell black or white. Okay, so we can color each cell either black or white as we want. The only requirement is that no two consecutive cells should be black. So if you consider two consecutive cells, they should be either both white or one white, one black, or one black and one white, but they cannot be both black. You cannot have two adjacent black cells. You have to say that how many ways do we have to color this rectangle such that this happens. For instance, if n is equal to 1, then we have only one cell and we can make it either white or black. Both of them work. So we have two ways. If n is equal to 2, we have two cells. We can make it white-white or white-black or black-white. But black-black is not allowed. So it is going to have three ways. So this is how it works for small n's. Now I want you to solve it for bigger n's as well. Assume that you want to write a code that it gives you some number n, and you have to say that what is the answer to this problem for this specific value of n. So how can you solve that? I want you to write the solution to this problem in the comments below. Also, if you wanted, I can make another video and solve this problem in that video. So if you had any question about these topics, memoization and dynamic programming, you can ask me in the comments below. I will try to answer all of your questions. Also, if there is another topic that you want me to talk about, you can tell me. And if you want to support my work and I want me to continue doing this, you can support me by liking this video and subscribing to my channel. Also, please send this video to everyone who might get help from this video. Thank you very much.